Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to use clipping masks in Affinity Designer. Clipping objects with masks in Affinity Designer is an important and powerful tool for vector illustration. It allows us to add various elements to a single shape or text. I have several examples I'll break down for you, but first I'm going to show you how to clip objects using masks in Affinity Designer. I'm going to start by creating a sphere, so I'm going to select our ellipse tool and holding shift and dragging to get a nice full circle. I'm going to change the color to a nice teal and add a radial gradient. Let's lighten up the highlight just a little bit and even darken our shadow here a little more. All right, so we've got a nice gradient. Gives us a nice spherical feel with the lighting. So a way to go ahead and we can create an additional shadow shape here to strengthen the shadow side. So we'll just create a large shape encompassing the whole area we want to cover. I'm gonna add a darker tone to it. Now I'm going to, with this new created shape here, I'm going to grab the shape in our layers panel, click and drag it into our ellipse shape, which is that sphere we have. Now you can see the shape I created for the shadow is locked inside this circular shape here. So with this shape clipped inside of our main circle, we could do a few different things here. I'm going to add a gradient to the shadow shape as well. Can lighten this section up just a little bit to create a little bit of bounce light. I can also come in here and select our shape. I can add a Gaussian blur to it. That'll fuzz out that main terminator shadow line there, giving us a more natural and rounded feel to the sphere itself. We can also add to this specular highlight. I'm going to switch these colors around to white. I'm going to take one of the points and lower that opacity down to 0. Change it to a radial gradient. So you see we have that nice specular highlight now. I can drag that shape into the ellipse. I'm gonna play around with the size and shape of it as well. Right up here. Now this will help strengthen the light on the light side. So we've been able to add our specular highlight and an additional shadow shape here to help continue to build out the circle and make it more of a sphere. All of our shapes are locked inside our main sphere here, which are manipulated simply by coming into the ellipse object and selecting that shape. So let's break down a couple of these examples real quick. We'll start with this circle shape here. We set this one up much like the example I just showed you, where we have our shadow shape clipped inside the main circle, as well as our specular highlight. This group here are the dots that I added. Placed all of these dots within the circle, and I added a gradient to them to help reflect our light source. So you see how these shapes are separate and built into our circle. Coming up here to masks, very similar situation. We just typed out masks. I created a bunch of ellipses with a white stroke. I then selected all of them and drag them in to my mask text. The same thing was done for our clipping text here with these various rectangle shapes to create a hashed shading to clipping. So we could do this with various shapes. And we can even continue to clip additional shapes inside of shapes we've already clipped. So we have this orange band clipped inside of our egg shape here. And if we come into this orange band, you can see we have a shadow shape here at the top and a reflected light shape here at the bottom. So this is a way that you can go ahead and build out various shapes for different elements of your illustration. You can also support the channel by donating. It helps me continue to create new tutorials and bring you new vector assets. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Please let me know in the comments below how you like to use clipping masks in Affinity Designer. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials coming soon. Keep chasing your dreams, and until next time.